of my righteousness. Look at somebody and say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
Oh, neighbor.
Oh, neighbor.
Don't worry.
Don't worry.
Because he's with you.
Right.
That's the wrong neighbor. That's the wrong neighbor. That's the wrong neighbor. I need you to find another. Look at that other neighbor. Say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
Oh, neighbor.
Oh, neighbor.
Don't worry.
Don't worry.
Because he's with you.
Because he's with you.
How many know God is with you?
Yes.
Even in times like this, you can rest assured that God is with you.
Yes.
He's with you. He's with you. He's with you. He's with you. He says, fear not. Don't worry. I know it seems a little rough right now. It seems a little dark right now. It seems helpless right now. But hold on, because God is right there.
Yeah. Yes.
He said, fear not. Don't even be dismayed, for I am with thee. He said, for I am thy God. I will strengthen thee. How many know when death comes, you need strength?
Amen.
I don't care. I don't care. Boo can be there. Babe can be there. Sister can be there. Brother can be there. Can't nobody hold you in times like these like God.
Amen.
So God said, don't worry. Don't worry who comes and who goes. I will never leave you.
That's right.
You can depend on me, for I am there with you. He said, I'll be your present help in the time of need.
Yes.
Do me one more favor. I promise I ain't gonna tell you to bother your neighbor no more. Can we get out of here? Say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
Oh, neighbor.
Oh, neighbor.
It's okay to cry.
It's okay to cry.
Now God is with you.
God is with you.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Oftentimes, people tell people when someone dies in their family, don't cry. Hush your mouth.
Amen.
You can't tell me how to cry. You can't tell me how to grieve. Especially if you ain't been where I'm going. Oftentimes, before someone lose a loved one, folks be so quick to say, I know how you're feeling. No, you don't. You know how I feel to lose a father, and you still got your daddy.
All right.
Can I talk real to somebody here? So oftentimes, we get caught up in emotions and telling people stuff that really don't make no sense.
Yeah.
Oh, you don't know crying, it's going to be all right. I know it's going to be all right. But the human side of me want to cry.
Yeah.
And I'm coming to tell somebody this morning, cry.
Yes, sir.
He's with you in the bad times.
Yes. Amen.
He's with you when folks around you. Mm-hmm. And he's with you when folks leave you. Mm-hmm. See, it's good now, family, because all the family's together. Mm-hmm. After all the chicken ate, Michelle, and Betty, after all the chicken gone, after all the green beans gone, and after all the pound cakes gone, and everybody gone to their separate lives. And it seems like it's just you by yourself. Give you a few words and let you know, trust in the Lord because he's right there with you.
Amen.
Yeah. Can I get a witness in here? Yeah. I can't tell you. For what about nobody else about to speak from experience? I know how you feel.
Yeah.
Been where you sit.
Right.
Yeah.
Just a couple years ago, lost my dad. And I know that God will be a father,
yes,
but the fatherless.
Yes.
He'll hold you, he'll comfort you in the midnight hour, he'll rock you.
Yes.
He'll love up on you.
Yes.
And don't want nothing else from you.
All right.
Oftentimes people comfort you in these times because they kept you at your most vulnerable state. I'm gonna preach in a minute. And what that means is that they know how to play on your emotions.
Yeah.
All right.
All right.
They know during this time folks is more vulnerable to accept and allow anything.
Watch out now.
Because they feel that everybody is there to comfort them. But I stopped trying to tell you, the Bible tells us to watch well and pray.
Yes.
Everybody don't mean you no good. Everybody ain't there to comfort you. Everybody ain't there to feel sorry for you. I stopped trying to tell you, I'm a knock on wood. Even family members sometimes can be
Yes.
If you need somebody that you can rest assured I'll be with you always. Can I take a few minutes to introduce you to a friend of mine?
Go ahead.
Before they did all that, he looked at him.
Yes, Lord.
And but you know, some of y'all were scared. But when you see cousin, then. Something on your your mind. I don't care what you do, you just can't enjoy.
Y'all ain't talking to me.
Yes, sir.
I don't care what it is that you used to find pleasure in, but when something is troubling your mind, it just won't let you enjoy it like it used to. So no matter what sin did, he just couldn't enjoy. He was worried about Jesus. So when he went on back, he looked at her. He looked down the road and seen death coming to meet him. He got poked up, said, come here, come here, sit down. I got to tell you something. Sin said, what's wrong, death? Say, well, last night, something happened strange.
Yes,
I don't understand it, and I can't explain it, but something happened. Sin said, well, what happened? Death said, about left there.
Yeah.
About left there. I think I just talked to you about left there. About left there, I started hearing some crazy noise, and I didn't know what's going on. And about 11:45, I'm seeing some movement going on in the grave. And about 11:50, things were getting rough. And about 11:55, I started to get real nervous. And I thought to put my hand on the bed, my other hand on Jesus. And about 11:57, I still had Jesus. At 11:58, I still had him, y'all. At 11:59, he was still in the grave. He broke it down and said, 11:59 and 30 seconds. And I still had him. 11:59 and 35 seconds. I still had him. May God keep you. Here's my prayer. Back in the hands of the dame she bought from.
Amen. Amen.